Good evening. Welcome to Frederick P. Rose Hall, the House of Swing. As we wind down the 2014-15 season, we just want to take a second to thank you. Thank you, thank you. Those of you tuning in on the web, as well as those in the auditorium tonight, we thank you for supporting us through this season, and we look forward to having you back in our next season. Please check our website, jazz.org, for information about the upcoming season. Now, tonight, the music of giants. Giants for real. They do walk the earth. And their spirits are here even once they leave us. The spirits never leave because you keep it here and we keep it here. The music tonight of Tito Puente and Frank Machito Grillo. Please welcome to the Rose Theater stage, the Jazz and Lincoln Center Orchestra, with our guest musical director for the evening, Mr. Carlos Enriquez.
We're gonna end this season right. All right, that's good. You know, there's so much to be said about these two giants, and I'm lucky and fortunate enough to have the ability to have been able to play with Tito Puente at a young age. I was just lucky, and I thank God that I was able to be around and see the little that I could and understand of this gentleman. And you know, it's unbelievable how we talk about jazz across the Americas and the pioneering of these two gentlemen and what they have done, not only for Latin music, but also in the America what jazz is. Tonight we have some great special guests. I want you guys to put your round of applause for these gentlemen. On trumpet, Mr. Pete Nader. On vocals, Mr. Marcos Bermudez. One of the living giants of this music, Mr. Jose Madera. On congas, Georgie Delgado. And on bongos, Mr. Johnny Dandy Rodriguez. All right, so as the set gets along, we'll talk more about these gentlemen to my right here who have so much influence on this music from not only their knowledge now, but because of their fathers, and we'll get to it as we go along. This first selection we're gonna play, it's a 1948 title recorded on Mercury. And it also features Mr. Jose Madera's dad, Jose Pin Madera. Yeah, let's give him a round of applause. It's composed by Antar Dari. It's titled, very hard to say if you say it fast or slow. It's entitled, Babaraba Tiri.
Batidi, batidi. Thank you. Machito, en su memoria.
Let's give it up for Marcos Bermudez. Paul Nazella on baritone. Georgie Delgado and Johnny Rodriguez.
All right. So now we leave Machito's side and we're going over to Puente side now. This one's a good one. This is a 1957 recording, Dance Mania. How many of you guys own that? Come on, clap. It's one of the greatest albums in the 20th century. This one's entitled Llegó Mi Hang. And it features on the recording Santos Colón and also Ray Barreto. Llegó Mi Hang.
Let's hear it for Ted Nash. Ted Nash on the flute.
All right, now we're gonna jump back to Macho's area now. So we're going back and forth. We're gonna have some fun doing this. This was a 1955 Seiko label. Title of the tune is entitled Mambo Sentimental. This one was composed by Emilio Duyari Yestazo.
Thank you.
crowd. Let's give it up for Dan Nimmer. Pete Nader on trumpet.
All right, so I know you've noticed on the billboards out there that my last name's up there. I'm gonna tell you why. You know, when we put this show together, you know, usually when you hear the big three, you always hear of Puente, Machito, and Rodriguez. You know, and let's give it up for Tito Rodriguez. So, you know, I was so anxious to put this show together when I spoke to Winton. And I said, look, you know, I really want to be a part of this somehow. You know, I told him. And he says, you know, man, why don't we just put your name up there with them? You knew Tito. You knew the Machito family at some point in your life. You know, why don't you contribute something? So I did. So for tonight's show, I contributed 4 original charts. And we will start with one of them today. You know, one thing I want you guys to know is that between the bands, between Puente and Machito, there was never a disgrace of them playing each other's music. The tune that you just heard, Mambo Sentimental, you know, it's Macho's tune, but Tito also played it many times. There was never this battle within, I mean, there was a competitive vibe amongst them because they were great bands. And Jose told me, well, one band was classy and one band was excitement. It was excitement. So, and for those who saw it, unfortunately, I'm 30 years too late. That's what they say. I was born in 79, so I'm sorry. Wish I was around. But this next tune is entitled The Bronze Pyramid. And this one is a tribute to Macho and Puente, but it also has a tribute to Juan Tizo, great Puerto Rican trombone player who worked with Duke Ellington. The Bronze Pyramid.
Thank you.
Thank you, Walter Blanding, Dan Emma, Paul Nazella, Vincent Garner, Marcus Prinup, Kenny Rampton.
Man, it's hard sometimes trying to get everybody up here. Ooh, all right. Get my mind thinking again. You know, I'm gonna take this time to express my gratitude and my love to both families. You know, today I'm able to have Puente's family here and a daughter of Machito's here. And I would like to turn on the lights and acknowledge these people if possible. Please turn on the lights and let's acknowledge the Puente family, please. I see Audrey, Ron, Tito Jr., Margie. I love you guys. Stand up. And we also have Marta Grillo here. If she's there. There she goes back there. There she goes. All right. So, you know, the beautiful thing about this music and the thing that's not supposed to die is the continuum of this music. And it's something that I've learned throughout my career as a musician. You know, the Puente family has done a great job of continuing Puente's music with Ronnie, with Tito Puente Jr., continuing the band around the world. And Mario's not able to attend today's show. Mario's another son of Machito who fronts the band and works the band. You know, this type of stuff has to continue, you know, for our youngsters to understand of that history and that culture that America loved deeply, and it's something that cannot be lost. So for those who support this, thank you. You know, and just one thing, I don't know if you know Audrey, but Audrey's the weather lady on TV. And I hate to put you on the spot, but you know, she always puts a real good day for this type of stuff. Thank you for bringing us some good weather. All right, let's continue with the show. This next selection is another title on a Dance Mania album, 57, entitled Agua Limpia Todo. Marcos Bermúdez.
A gozar todo el mundo. La 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 Muchísimas gracias, los maestros. Gracias.
Let's give it up for Marcos Bermúdez.
How many of you guys were able to go to a pre-lecture today? Did some of you guys go? All right. Well, we're lucky enough to have in this world with us now somebody who knows pretty much, I would say, the bulk of the music of Mr. Puente. This gentleman has done so much for me for this show. You know, when I put the show together, you know, the easy part about putting Puente's show together, right? It could be easy and just call out Oye Como Va, Ran Can Can, stuff that's already been heard a lot by many people. But the hard thing was to go deep into the can and to pick out stuff that was very dedicated musically. You know, us musicians really take the time to write stuff and really write really creative things. And sometimes those are not things that become things that become popular. But Mr. Joe Conzo Sr., I want to give him a round of applause for those who don't know who he is. He was kind enough to sit me down and nurture me with all the information that I needed to know. And there was a lot of things that I didn't have right. You know, sometimes you go online and things are not in this right format, as we say. So thank God that the people like him are around. And to his credit, you know, he wrote a beautiful book that I've been reading, Mambo Diablo, the story of Tito Puente. Those who don't have it should jump on it. It tells you the story about Puente and the lifestyle and Machito ever and all that good stuff. So I just want to say thank you, Joe, that I'm up here. All right, so before we end this first set, this tune is another original composition. And it was written in 2010 of October, but it falls perfectly for this event, Jazz Across the Americas. Now, we were invited to attend a residency in Cuba in 2010. It was the first time Jazz Lincoln Center was heading to Cuba. And we had a great exchange, a musical exchange program there. It was unbelievable, so much to learn. And they asked me to write a tune. And I wrote a tune, and it basically explained everything that this season was about, Jazz Across the Americas, how much influence the Americas, and not just North America, I'm talking about South America, Central America, Mexico, you name it, how much influence we have as Americans to understand how much that music is a part of us too. This tune is entitled Two Threes Adventure, and it talks about the clave. For those who don't know what the clave is, it's a pattern that we use in our music that if, there you go, that's it. All right. Let's take it to the coda. All right. All right, you guys know what the coda is, that's good. So listen, at the start of this tune, we'll practice that, we'll get you. But this tune talks about the movement of the 2-3 clave. It starts off on a Puedes Plado quote vibe, and it wanders around, and then it goes into a jazz swing vibe. And then it jumps back to a mambo, then it jumps into a guajira. Then it stays inside of the guajira, then it jumps back to jazz, then it goes back to a little bit of a mambo. Then all of a sudden, it starts to fall apart into Let Me Take a Solo, which is not bad. But then after I take the solo, it decides to flip to 3-2. I don't know why, but that's what happens, and that's how the story ends. And tonight, I want to introduce a house name here at the House of Swing. This gentleman, you guys know, he doesn't really need an introduction. But the one thing I want to say, this gentleman is very dedicated to the music. He just did a great show here on the music of Max Roach. For those who did not see that, he did a wonderful job. And this gentleman is our drummer, and he will be featured on this tune, Mr. Ali Jackson. You know, the drums has been very influenced in Latin music. Some people say, hey, why are the drum set is playing in there? I just found out today that Puente himself played traps. Willie Bobo played traps in those bands. I remember Willie Bobo on albums, but there were other musicians, Mikey Collazo, who played. So even though the drum set is not prominent on those recordings, they were out there. So the drum set is also a part of this music. 2-3's Adventure. Enjoy. Thank you.
Let's give it up for Ali Jackson. That's right, Ali. Kenny Rampton. Also, Vincent Garner. All right, that's entitled Cuckoo's Adventure. We're gonna take a short intermission. Don't leave. Go out and have some fun and come back for the second set. There's more special guests. Thank you.
You ready?